Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching, subscribing to the channel guys. If you have a Chevy vehicle guys, Chevy Buick, you can find a list of the vehicle listed in the description of the video below guys, and you're trying to replace the transmission output speed sensor guys, stay with us, we'll show you how to do that. This should work guys on a 6 T30, T35, 6 T40, T45 and T50 transmission. This same transmission guys is used on Chevy Cruze, Malibu, Equinox, Terrain, Buick and many more vehicles. You can see them listed in the description of the video below. So if that sensor doesn't work guys, your transmission may even fail to work as well. Because this is the one that tells how fast things are moving inside the transmission speed sensor, output speed sensor. So we're demonstrating here on a Chevy Cruze guys, but as I said, it will be the same, about the same procedure for all of them with some minor differences. So we'll guys go ahead, start from the very beginning, show you what needs to be done and we'll continue. Now it's very important, the first step will be to drain the transmission oil, but you want to do that when the transmission is cold, that way you will be able to get the most of the oil out. Because if you drain the transmission when it's warm, you will only get about 50% of the oil out. So let's go ahead and start on the process now. Now we'll go ahead, remove the front end of the car, the bumper and all that stuff, so we can video everything and show you with a great detail where things are. So let's start on that one now. So we have the car on jack stands. We have the tires in the air a little bit. So we can get under the vehicle, but being on a lift will be more convenient guys. Always use jack stands, not just the jack itself, because if it fails you will be in big trouble. Now underneath the vehicle, let me show you now guys quick. Underneath the vehicle, that's where your transmission is located, and you can see you have a drain plug guys. Right there, this is your drain plug. So this is with 11 millimeter socket now. 11 millimeter socket, and we'll go ahead and get it off. Now some people, what they do, they drive the car for a little bit before they drain it so they can warm up the fluid, but the exhaust will be extremely hot, you can burn yourself. So if you don't feel confident, don't actually get it hot. Now stay with us guys to show you, you will not believe how black that oil is, and the car has only 37,000 miles guys. That oil is extremely black, I cannot believe that it's so bad. So this is the drain plug. Let me show you quick what it looks like. That little bitty guy right here, this is your transmission drain plug. So we're going to drain it all the way and we'll show you how much we got out. Guys, so we're ready to install it. Practically it drained all the way. We're going to get it tight now, do not leave it for later guys. One thing never to forget. Perfect. Now let's pull it out and show you how much we got guys and how black the fluid is. With only 37,000 miles on the car, just like that. So now we're going to go ahead and we'll remove that thing for the transmission lines to lift it up a little bit, that holder there. Perfect. It will come off later, we can pull it. It will be a little bit more convenient if we pull it towards the back. Or just take it off. Let's see if it's going to come off. And later we can install it. Guys, now we're going to need a I need to remove that clip there, you can see, for the cable. And you need to make sure that your car battery is disconnected before you start working on your transmission. First thing guys, we need to disconnect the car battery, so do that. Now let us show you guys. We're going to remove that clip. Okay, that clip we'll leave it for later. What we'll attempt to do now, okay, to remove that bolt here, okay, and see if we can move the cables a little bit up, if we're going to gain a little bit of room. Okay, we will. What we need to do though, okay, we need to disconnect the transmission cable now, and later, okay, we'll be able to go ahead and actually, okay, you can see you need to push it in, move the cables a little bit up. Okay, this thing will come out. Now, right there is, okay, that tube you need to press in. Okay, let me get a little bit of a better view because it's almost impossible for me to show you. Okay, that tube needs to be pressed in, and then you just open the clip all the way. Okay, and you can disconnect the transmission cable. Okay, you can see, guys, just like that. Okay, so we're going to disconnect the cable from that hose right there. Okay, this cable there on the side as well, guys. Now we need to pull that clip still that holds, okay, that cable there. You can see why I removed the bumper so we can show you things in a better way. Perfect. Now we have one 10 millimeter bolt that we need to remove on top. And once we remove that bolt, guys, we will be able to remove the cables. Okay, let's move the hand later so I can show exactly where it is. Okay, this is the bolt. Now that metal plate will come out later. We need to install it. Okay, so it's not in the way, guys. You can see just like that. Now we can pull those cables up, and we're going to use a heavy-duty zip tie to tie them up so they don't fall. Okay, so we'll just pull them up here so they're not in the way, and we don't want to damage anything. Okay, just like that. So 8 millimeter socket now, we start removing, okay, bolts on the open. You can see where ours developed a leak, guys. You can definitely notice that transmission is leaking there a little bit. This one is a little bit hard to get to. Okay, perfect. Now we have a few more. Okay, guys, we started dripping oil. Okay, you can see we started dripping oil. Even though we drain it, we'll still have some, okay? No matter how well you drain it, you'll still leak some. So, we're going to go ahead now. We should be able to pull the cover out. Okay, I don't think anything else is in the way right now. Okay, you can see what it looks like. Okay, gently. For without, guys. Okay, just like that, you can see. Alright guys, so now we need to disconnect a few wires. Okay, this one came out. Careful not to break it, guys. Okay, another one. Now we have one on bottom. Okay, perfect. This one is loose as well. Now, we're going to get a 10mm socket, guys. Okay, and we'll start removing a few bolts now. Okay, let's grab the tools quick and see if we can remove all these bolts and pull that that valve body out of the way now. One is out. Very long bolt. Two. Three. Okay, you can see, guys, four bolts so far. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Then we have 10. And we have 11 and 12 on top, guys. Perfect, okay, just like that. Now let's see. Okay, this wire is going through there. We need to gently pull it out. Okay, so it's not in the way. Okay, let's see what else is holding there. Because we still have more bolts holding. That way we can remove it. I believe probably the little ones, okay, with that 8mm, I think it's an 8, will need to be removed as well. Okay guys, so 7mm now. Okay, let's see if this is a long bolt. Yep, definitely guys, these three bolts will need to be removed. Okay, perfect. Now, let's see if that complete assembly here is going to come out. Okay, and it did, guys. Okay, this is it. Okay guys, so in order to remove the valve body, we need to get a 10mm socket now. And we need to start removing a few bolts. We'll show you where. There is one small bolt in the corner that you should not remove. Okay, the valve body is getting loose now, guys. So you have to support it. Okay, more fluid will come out. Okay, you can see we're still draining it. And we're going to pull it out. Okay, just like that. So now we grab that plate gently. You have to pull it out. Okay, came out like that, guys. Now, the output speed transmission sensor, guys, okay, is right there. Let me show you in a second where the sensor is, and we'll show you guys how to remove it. Okay, this is your sensor right there. So we need to remove it only with that bolt right there. Okay guys, 10mm socket. We're going to remove the bolt. Okay, now you grab the sensor. You have to be careful not to pinch that wire later. And this is it, guys. You can see, not too complicated, but not too easy to do it as well. So you can find in the description of the video below, guys, where we got our where we get our replacement sensor from. This is it. Putting it together, you have to be extremely careful to put the wire the same location where it was going, so you don't pinch it. So hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you guys having that problem. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.